Jaya Jaya Navala Kishore Jaya Gopi Chit Chora Prabho Jaya Jaya Makhana Chore Jaya Jaya Makhana Chore श्री कृष्ण चंद्र भगवान की जगत गुरु शील प्रभुपा उपस्थित
हरे कृष्णा All glories to Srila Prabhupada, Guru and Gauranga. Please accept my humble obeisances. I extend my heartfelt gratitude and warm welcome to all the senior Vaishnavas of International Society for Krishna Consciousness. I also welcome each one of the devotees who have assembled here on Zoom platform and who very regularly participate in this katha on platforms like YouTube and Facebook. I would like to extend immense thanks to the host family, to this 310th katha, Patel family from United States of America, Bhavnaven and Rasik Bhai, her son, Chaitan, and daughter-in-law, Priya, and their kids, Revya and Kiara, and also the daughter of Bhavnaven, Dr. Gopi, and also their son-in-law, Mukesh Bhai, and their kids, Arav and Ayan. So I welcome each one of the members of the Patel family to the third day session of this 310th Katha. And I also welcome all the guests and devotees invited by Patel family. Hare Krishna, Radhe Shyam. The epitome of love, the gopis. In this Gopi Geet, attempt to express their love, mood and affection towards Lord Krishna. And as they express their most emotion and sentiment towards Lord Krishna, they express their prayer and desire that, O Shri Krishna, should go ahead and offer their darshanams to the gopis. And also they further say that Shri Krishna must place his lotus feet on their breasts.
Nam trina charanugam shri niketanam pani panarpitam te padambujam Kruṇu kucheshu na krindhini chayam. Hey Krishna.
So the gopis say, O Shri Krishna, O Shyam Sundar,
रख लेकर हमारे हृदय की कामना कृपया करके आप दूर कीजिए.
So the gopis go on to say to Shri Krishna, O Shri Krishna, O Shri Shyam Sundar, we request you to place those divine feet on our hearts to get us rid of all the sorrows and soothe our burning desires. So today I want to raise a question to each one of you. So the question that I'm posing before you, I should be able to get to know, what is your mental exercise and your mental diet? So the question is,
पाप कर्षनम, यहाँ पर गोपिया पाप की बात कर रही है. और अब तो
इन द श्लोका यू सी द गोपीज आर टॉकिंग अबाउट सिंस.
तो पाप की बात आई यहाँ पर इस श्लोक में.
सो बिकॉज सिंस आर बीइंग टॉक्ड अबाउट, सो माय क्वेश्चन इज, so my question is that
Krishna mil jane ke baad,
so is it that you get absolved of all your sins after having attained Lord Shri Krishna, or that Lord Krishna can be attained only when your sins are absolved?
Itna granth padhte ho, kuch iskon wale to baantte bhi hain, lekin iska jawab de do chalo aaj mujhe. प्रश्न समझ में आ गया. मैं आपके चेहरे देखना चाहता हूँ. तमे आम धोयला मुळानी जेम तो नथी बैठा ने.
So I hope all of you have understood my question. So let me repeat the question once more. So is it so that your sins will be absolved once you attain Lord Shri Krishna, or that you will be able to attain Lord Shri Krishna only once your sins are absolved?
Krishna milenge baad mein paap se mukt honge, to aap ek ungli dikhaiye aur paap khatam ho jane ke baad Krishna milenge isme jo hai wo do ungli bataiye. Chalo main dekh raha hu yahan par sab dikhai de rahe hain. Acha to hamare devang ji bol rahe hain ke पहला कृष्ण मिलने के बाद पाप. अच्छा रसिक जो घर में झगड़ो छे बोलो आपड़े शू कर
बोल रहे हैं कि दो भावना माता कहती एक.
सो अच्छा पंकज प्रभु एक बोल रहे हैं कृष्ण मिलने के बाद पाप दूर होंगे.
नहीं नहीं
तो मतलब ये तो आधा आधा और हो गया. आधे लोग बोल रहे हैं कि कृष्ण मिलने के बाद पाप से मुक्त होंगे. आधे लोग कहते हैं कि पाप से मुक्त होने के बाद कृष्ण मिलेंगे. देखिए हमें ज्यादा दूर कहां जाना है, गोपियों के पास ही चले जाए. हम तो कहें ना गोपी गीत के आजू बाजू में, गोपी गीत भी छोड़ो सातवें श्लोक के तीन दिन से आजू बाजू में.
So you see, I can see every devotee is presenting different kind of answer.
किसी इस एंगल से देख रहे हैं, कुछ ये एंगल से, कुछ इसके भाव को. तो गोपियों से आगे तो चैतन्य महाप्रभु ने कह दिया कुछ होने.
So let us try to, you see, seek the answer to that question by way of gopis. Gopi is the epitome of love and affection.
तत्कालीन ऐसा कुछ नहीं कि भाई कुछ लोग कविता बनाते हैं तो थोड़ा दिमाग यूज करते हैं ना, भाई ये लिखना है, ये राइमिंग वर्ड को ऐसे डालना है, ये राइम होना चाहिए. मतलब सोच समझ कर गोपियों ने ये गीत नहीं गाया. जब कोई व्यक्ति अपना भाव प्रकट करता है तो सोचता थोड़ी है.
So you see, when gopis expressed their love and affection, they did not give a thought. They only went on to offer their mood and affection. So they presented their गीत spontaneously. But our acharyas, our commentators, went on to combine
को तो ये सब पता नहीं था ना
and interpret the Geet of the Gopis in the light of our Shastras. So the Gopis had offered their Geet spontaneously, and the commentators went on to interpret the Geet of the Gopis in the light of the different Shastras and Vedas. So you see, in what way, that how come the Gopi Geet of the Gopis establishes a relationship with the different verses of the Vedas. So the first question is, whether you will be absolved of the sins after having met Krishna, or once that you meet Krishna and then you are absolved of the sins. So sometimes we falter because of lack of the fact that we have not surrendered to the lotus feet of the spiritual master. And that is the reason, even after practicing spirituality for a long time, we end up committing some mistake.
लेकिन अपने आप को सोचिए.
So you see, हमारे अंदर ये ताकत है. Do we really have the strength that we can be absolved of all the sins all by ourselves? Do we have that energy, power and strength that we can get rid of all our sins? So you see, I personally feel that perhaps you might have the power, strength and energy, those who chose the second option. So let us go and ask the answer to this question. So you see, what Gopi's answer? So you see, the words of the first line.
प्रोसेस क्या होती है पाप कर्षणम क्रम यहीं पर लिखा है पंकज जी एडवोकेट है ना इसलिए वो थोड़े दिमाग लगा कर देख लिए भाई ये क्रम मतलब इसलिए उन्होंने कहा कि पहले कृष्ण मिलेंगे गोपियां कहती हैं अब मैं फिर से कहूं गोपियों ने तो ये भाव कह दिया दिमाग नहीं लगा
गोपीज एक्सप्रेस्ड देयर माइंड एंड हार्ट दे ओनली एक्सप्रेस्ड देयर फीलिंग मूड emotion and sentiment.
Ke pehle pranat pranat mane pranam.
So what did the gopis go on to say? That first they surrender to the lotus feet of Shri Krishna.
Jab pranat dehi naam dehdhari jeev jab pranam karta hai tab paap karshanam tab sare paap dur hote hain.
So all the sins of those are destroyed who surrender to your lotus feet. So the sins are absolved off once you surrender to the lotus feet. So who do you surrender to? So the meaning is, when Krishna is before us and then we would surrender to him, and that is how our sins would be absolved of. So you see, all the sins of those are destroyed who shall surrender to the lotus feet of Shri Krishna. So the sequence is, first you attain Lord Shri Krishna and then you get absolved of all your sins. So when the living entity meets Shri Krishna, offers himself to Shri Krishna, surrenders to the lotus feet of Shri Krishna, and that is how he gets absolved of all the sins. So the sequence is, first we shall meet and attain Lord, and then we will be absolved of all the sins. So you see, Lord Shri Krishna was not that away and distant from the gopis. But practically, if we see ourselves, then if we believe that we would be absolved of all our sins after having attained Lord Shri Krishna, then the fact is too distant is Lord placed from us. Then the living entity like us, an ordinary living entity like us, if we need to get absolved of all our sins, become free of all our sins, we must attain Lord Shri Krishna. And what is the way out to attain Shri Krishna? So you see, if you ask me, even to this day, in this material world, age of Kali Yuga, we can attain Lord Shri Krishna. So, Shri Sod Goswami goes on to say, there is no difference between Shri Krishna and the Katha of Shri Krishna. So when you listen to the story of Shri Krishna, the pastime of Shri Krishna, it is as good as saying that you're sitting beside Shri Krishna. So let me illustrate this. Srimad Bhagvatam, first canto, second chapter. So the shloka is there before you at the bottom. There is no difference between Shri Krishna and the pastime and story of Shri Krishna. So what do we need to do in order to get absolved of all our sins? We must listen to Swa Katha, means the story and the pastime of Shri Krishna, because there's no difference between the stories and narrations of Shri Krishna and Shri Krishna himself. So when we listen to the stories and Katha of Shri Krishna, it is as good as saying that we attain Shri Krishna. And you see, Shri Krishna's Katha offers you so the Katha of Shri Krishna goes on to purify you. So the Rishi in the status of Namisharanya went on to ask the question, so is it that one goes on to purify himself by only listening to the story of the Lord, story of Lord Shri Krishna? The answer was yes, because there is no difference between the name of the Lord and the Katha of the Lord. So the logic is, when we listen to the pastimes of Shri Krishna, so as the story, as the Katha enters the eardrums, it is like Shri Krishna himself is entering into our eardrums and into ourselves. So by way of story, by way of narration, by way of pastimes being heard, Shri Krishna enters our heart. And if you talk about us, the people of this Kali Yuga, there is so much of dust and dirt in our hearts. Lust, anger, false ego, pride, etc. So as Shri Krishna enters the heart of the living entity of age of Kali Yuga, even Lord Shri Krishna would be quite irritated to enter such a heart. But by that time, the second day arrives, and again, the Gopi Gita is being heard by the living entity of this age of Kali Yuga, and again Shri Krishna makes an attempt to go away. But in that process, this person again and again, you see, this living entity listens to my Katha, to the Katha of Shri Krishna. So Krishna decides that he shall stay in the heart of such a person. So once Lord Shri Krishna decides that Shri Krishna shall have to stay in the heart of that living entity, then he shall first of all take a decision that the foremost task is to clean that heart. So you see, if a house or room is closed for a long time, Then you see, in order to stay there, you first need to clean that up. So when Sri Krishna arrives in our heart to stay in our heart, first of all, what he does is to clean our hearts by himself. And how does he clean that? So the term is dhunoti, means to wash or to clean. Vidhunoti means to wash and to clean by a particular method. So Sri Krishna cleanses our heart in such a particular manner that despite several efforts, it cannot be polluted again. So this is the utterance of Sudh Goswami in Amesharanya, and also the same illustration is by Sudh Goswamiji to Parikshit Maharaj. So if you see at the bottom of your screen, the shloka comes from Sri Sudh Goswami to Parikshit Maharaj. So the question is, Sudh Goswami says, how does Sri Krishna enters in our heart? So Sudh Goswami ji answers that Sri Krishna enters our heart by way of our ears, by our auditory nerves. Sri Krishna enters our body, and he makes way to enter in our heart. And then you see, Sukhdev Goswami goes on to say, as Sri Krishna enters us by way of our auditory passage and enters our heart, so he comes along with the broom to cleanse the heart. And that is how he goes on to clean and purify our heart. So assuming if Parikshit Maharaj raised a question that how does Sri Krishna cleanses our heart, so Sudh Goswami would have answered that just as in the winter season, the waters of lakes, ponds and rivers automatically cleanses itself. Similarly, Lord Sri Krishna cleanses our heart and removes all the dirt and pollution. So the conclusion is, it is not that first you would be getting yourself cleansed and absorbed of all the sins. Rather, the underlying principle is, after having attained Lord Sri Krishna, we will be absolved of all our sins. So the question is, how to attain Lord Sri Krishna? And the answer is by listening to the stories and pastimes of Sri Krishna. And other than the kathas, pastimes, narrations, etc., there are many other things, as the gopis say. The gopis say that to offer pranams, and even Sudh Goswami and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also said to offer obeisances at the lotus feet of the Lord, and also to do shravan and kirtanam. And we are all very fortunate that by the mercy of Srila Prabhupada and by the blessings of our Guru Maharaj, we all are listening to the story of Srimad Bhagavat Katha every day. And in this manner, Sri Krishna cleanses our hearts and we make a move towards Bhagavad Prem. So this was Pranat Dehi Naam. So if I move further, so Pranat Dehi Naam, Pap Karshanam. So one of the commentators, one of the Acharyas, elaborates upon Pap Karshanam, that there are two methods and solutions to do away with the sins. In order to become free of sins, there are two methods, there are two ways. One of the method is, that must become so big, must you rise so high that the sin appear belittle before you. So you must evolve to such a huge extent that the sin appear very tiny before you. So if you evolve to a very high level, that perhaps the sin would not trouble you. So to evolve and become mature is the method of sages, saints and those who meditate. So, you know, such kind of sadhu saints, they say that they would become Brahm and they would disappear in Brahm. So, such a sage is actually the knowledgeable one. But what is the other alternative? The other alternative is to transform yourself so tiny and tiny and such a tiny form that sins may not be able to touch you or to get hold of you. So you see how easy it is to tie an elephant, but you think it's easy to tie an ant. So imagine how tough it is to tie the ant, and how easy it is to tie an elephant. So, Gyanmarg says that you evolve to a high level, but you see, when you go on to transform yourself into tiny and tiny of the form, this is Bhakti Marg. So, when gopis were asked which Marg or which method suits you the most, the gopi says that we want to become small and tiny to such an extent that no sins would be able to touch us. So the shloka by gopis is pranat dehi nam papakarshanam. So the gopis go on to say that we don't want to evolve and mature ourselves. We would rather want to stay small by staying humble. So Bhakti Marg is all about that you should consider yourself small. And Gyan Marg is all about evolving yourself maturely. So in the Bhakti Marg, you see what happens. That there is no fear because you become so humble. So in Bhakti Marg, it is more about being humble. So when Hanumanji, when entered into Lanka to search for Sita ji, and as he was traveling across the ocean, you see, he came across many obstacles. And one of those obstacles was Sursa. You see, the demoness Sursa. So Sursa opened her mouth, and Lord Hanuman also gained size, and even Sursa went on to increase the size of her mouth. So now, as this demoness was increasing her mouth, so was Shri Hanuman. But all of a sudden, Lord Hanuman took a very tiny form. And that way he saved the situation for himself. Such is also the mood of Gopi. So we must always stay humble and grounded so that we cannot get entangled. We should not be getting entangled. So Gopi say that we want to stay humble and that we always want to offer our obeisances. So this expression of humility by gopis. So the gopis further go on to say, O Shri Krishna, you have abandoned us, you're not appearing before us. For sure, there is no doubt, for sure, it is we who must be at fault. For sure, there must be some sin or crime committed by us. But O Shri Krishna, we belong to you. We are already surrendered to you. That there are sins in us, we accept. So the gopi's affectionate mood is, that we belong to you and that we are full of sins, but we surrender to your lotus feet. Now, dear devotees, you see, if a member of your family has certain shortcomings, certain problems, certain flaws, then would you abandon that person? No. Would you abandon that family member? No. The answer is, staying beside them, we shall attempt to help them overcome that shortcoming, flaw, or issue. So gopis are making a request to Sri Krishna that we have certain shortcomings, flaws. Please stay around us, stay by us, and punish us as you punished Kaliya. We are ready to undergo punishment. We are ready to improvise upon our mistakes, but should you always stay with us? So in this manner, in the seventh shloka, gopis places a request to Sri Krishna.
देहि नाम देहधारी जीव आपको प्रणाम करे तो आप
so श्लोक का विशेषता है कि goes on to say that if the living entity surrender to your lotus feet, then your lotus feet has all the capacity to absolve the living entity of all his sins. So may you please place such divine feet on our hearts. So, imagining if Sri Krishna would say, why should he be placing his feet on the hearts of gopis? So, gopis would answer that if you can place your feet for the cows in the grazing fields, then why can't you place your lotus feet on our hearts? So the gopi says that the feet which follows the footsteps of cows in the grazing field. The gopi say your lotus feet goes on to follow the footsteps of the cows and oxes. So imagining if Sri Krishna would not like this preposition of the gopis. Imagining, assuming if Sri Krishna would say that if the gopis were trying to say that everyone comes and offers all the sins to my lotus feet and then they leave, that means everybody is sending their sins to my lotus feet. That means all my feet are full of sins. And also you're trying to say that my feet only follow the footsteps of cows in the grazing field. That instead of being padarvind,
matlab mere charanon
mein have gone on to become quite rough. So is it that you're trying to say? So Sri Krishna would say, okay, you go away, I won't come to you. Now, assuming this, gopis went on to say further that, oh Krishna, don't you please misunderstand us. So you see, this was not actually happening between the gopis and Krishna. But gopis then go on to explain, oh Sri Krishna, what we are trying to say that your lotus feet has huge glory. And then they go on to say that your lotus feet is the living face of Goddess Lakshmi. The gopis goes on to say that your lotus feet is the eternal face of Goddess Lakshmi. So, you see, Sri Krishna in a way is again being attempted to be pleased by the gopis. So, the gopis go on to say, your lotus feet is the eternal place of Goddess Lakshmi. So, gopis go on to say, oh Shri Krishna, kindly place those divine feet on our hearts to get us rid of all the sorrows and soothe our burning desires. So Sripad Sanatan Goswami goes on to say, Sri Niketana means, so imagine if Lord Krishna would say, so if you can see the shloka at the bottom of your screen. So let's say, imagining if Sri Krishna was to tell to gopis that your heart is very pure and divine, and such beautiful, tender heart, how can I place my feet?
इतने कोमल इतने सुंदर इतने सुष्टु इतने शोभनीय हृदय कमल पर मैं कैसे मेरा चरण रख दूं तब गोपिया कहती हैं श्री
निकेतन द गोपीज गो ऑन टू से फर्दर ओ श्री कृष्णा दैट आवर हार्ट इज ऑफ नो वैल्यू बिफोर योर लोटस फीट बिकॉज़ योर लोटस फीट हैव लक्ष्मी जी and Ganga ji. So Sanatana Goswami goes on to say that the lotus feet of Sri Krishna is the eternal place of Goddess Lakshmi. So you see,
devotees,
this is such an engrossing language, which is Sanskrit. So Sripad Sanatan Goswami goes on to say that assuming if Sri Krishna was to say that how can, assuming that if Sri Krishna was to say that, how can I place my feet on your heart? So gopis would answer that, O Sri Krishna, that the beauty of our height is only because of you. So
the gopis
go on to say that more valuable than anything else, it is your lotus feet.
वास्तविक हमारे हृदय का अलंकार वो सोना गहना चैन ये नहीं है.
The real ornament of our heart is not gold, silver or precious stones, but rather it is your lotus feet, which is the real decoration.
और सभी अलंकारों की अलंकार साक्षात लक्ष्मी देवी जो आपके चरणों में बैठी हैं. और ऐसे श्री कर श्री निकेतनम ऐसे चरण कमल हमारे हृदय में.
Imagining if
गोपियों का अद्भुत भाव आज कृष्ण के सामने प्रस्तुत हो रहा है. कृष्ण के चरणों की महिमा गोपियों ने कहा श्री निकेतनम.
The gopis go on to now elaborate upon the stories of Sri Krishna. Now you see, once it so happened that Lakshmi ji was given the place in the heart of Lord Vishnu.
And Lakshmi ji, apne Gujarati ma ken harak phadura thain Bhagwan na vakshasthal ma besi gaya. Bhagwan ne kya soch ke Lakshmi ji ko hriday.
Now, what might have made the Lord to let Lakshmi ji sit in the heart? Perhaps Lord might have thought that so many people come to have my darshan. And because they come from my darshan, so I also need to, you see, be formally placed. And just in case if I make Lakshmi sit beside me, then people would certainly focus upon her and that I shall be spared. So you see, in a way, what is happening is when an individual goes on to toss aside everything in search of the Lord, and that is when Sri Krishna would decide to come to that devotee. So that way Sri Krishna ensured So you see, Lakshmi ji also accepted the offer of sitting beside Sri Krishna. Now Lakshmi ji observed for a while, staying on the heart of Sri Krishna, and then after some time Lakshmi ji realized that staying in the heart of Sri Krishna is a huge loss. Then Lakshmi ji goes on to place a request to Sri Krishna that Lakshmi ji be made to come out of the heart of Sri Krishna. So Lakshmi ji says that, "Oh Sri Krishna, I have no intention to sit in your heart, but I want to stay at your lotus feet." So Sri Krishna would say that where is Tulsi Devi? It is at the lotus feet of Lord. Tulsi is not even offered to the lotus feet of Radharani. Lakshmi ji went on to say that it is okay with her to stay as Swatan to Tulsi Devi. Then Sri Krishna said, all the devotees go on to stay at my lotus feet only. So Sri Krishna said, all great devotees are there at my lotus feet. Lakshmi ji said that there is no need to worry. I shall also stay at the lotus feet. And then what happens? And then Lakshmi ji went on to go after Sri Krishna to get a place at the lotus feet of Sri Krishna. Then you see, Sri Krishna went on to say that, oh Lakshmi, already there are gopis at my lotus feet, and then you must follow their footsteps, to which Lakshmi ji agreed. So in Srimad Bhagavatam it is said,
Shriyat Padambujaraja Shchakame Tulasya Labdhva Pivakshasi Padam Kila Kila Vrutya Jushtam Yasya Swavikshana Yuta Nyasura Prayasa Tat Tat Vayam Chatavapa Daraja Prapanna. Dekhi, is shlok ko samajhne ke liye dusri line se...
To understand the shloka, we must begin from the second line.
सूर शब्द को पकड़ लीजिए सूर माने देवता
so sur means devta the demigods so one glance of lakshmi ji so in order to have one glance of lakshmi ji so many demigods go on to stand in queue
कब होगी लक्ष्मी जी की कृपा और ऐसी
श्रीमद इवन दे लुक फॉरवर्ड वेरी ईगरली व्हेन दे वुड बी ब्लेस्ड बाय लक्ष्मी जी सो सच देवी लक्ष्मी यू सी इवन द डेमिगॉड्स आर इन द रेस टू अटेन सच लक्ष्मी जी So coming to the first noun, such Lakshmi Ji is sitting at the lotus feet of the Lord. So despite the fact that Sri Krishna cautioned Lakshmi Ji that even Tulsi Maharani stays at the lotus feet of the Lord, but still Lakshmi Ji abandoned the heart of Sri Krishna and placed herself at the lotus feet of Sri Krishna. Then the gopis go on to say further that because the story and the pastime of your lotus feet is so huge that even Lakshmi Ji abandons your heart in order to stay at a lotus feet. That means, O Sri Krishna, there is immense significance and glory of your lotus feet. And that is the reason, O Shri Krishna, we are making an humble attempt to offer our obeisances to you. So in this manner, the gopis go on to say, so, You see, it is said that so assuming that if the gopis had this mood as if Sri Krishna was to say that you asked me to place my feet on your heart, I am very much fearful about it. So Vishwanathi, so Chakravarti Thakur go on to say that, so Chakravarti Pad goes on to say that, that oh gopis, you are requesting me to place my feet on your heart.
Vibhemi, mujhe dar lag raha hai. कि कहीं गोपियों आपके
फियरफुल चल गया तो डंडे लेकर आएंगे मुझे पीटेंगे अबाउट योर हस्बैंड दैट इफ योर हस्बैंड्स गेट टू नो अबाउट दिस एक्ट दे वुड कम हिटिंग मी विद देयर लॉन्ग स्टिक्स एंड आई एम वेरी मच फियरफुल ऑफ योर हस्बैंड्स व्हाट इफ दे ऑल कम टुगेदर एंड बीट मी अप देन गोपीज गो ऑन टू रिप्लाई इन द श्लोका फणी फणार पीतम माने व्हिच इज बिफोर योर स्क्रीन्स
तो किमुत्तेभ्य इति भावः जब आपने कालीय नाग के मस्तक पर अपना चरण रखने में कोई डर
द गोपीज गो ऑन टू से यू नेवर थॉट फॉर अ सेकंड थॉट व्हेन यू प्लेस योर लोटस फीट ऑन द हुड ऑफ कालिया प्रभु आप ऐसा मत कहिए आप ऐसे सो प्लेसिंग योर लोटस फीट ऑन आवर हस्बैंड is not a big deal. So Shibashidhar Goswami go on to say Bhagavan Sri Krishna ki veerta ko bata rahi hai that gopis here are attempting to explain the bravery of Sri Krishna.
Krishna ke asamardh veerta ka शब्द के द्वारा करती हैं कृष्णा आप में कितनी
वीरता है. So the gopis go on to narrate and elaborate upon the qualities of Shri Krishna.
और आप कहते हो कि हमारे पतियों से आपको डर लग रहा है.
And you are attempting to say that you are fearful of our husbands. My dear devotees, we all must listen to all these narrations in a very dedicated mood. So you see, the material husbands of the gopis, such husbands also have Shri Krishna in their hearts. So who runs the body, the physical body of the physical entity, who are the husbands of these gopis? It is Shri Krishna, because Shri Krishna is present in the heart of every individual. So pati or husband means the one who fends, the one who caters. Ultimately, you see, in this material world, all of us are sustained by Shri Krishna. And that is the reason, you see, that social system, etc. So if you see it by way of elements, then that it is Shri Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is the husband to each one of us. So, Shukdev Goswami then go on to say further that in this material world, so it is Shri Krishna who is the ultimate husband for everyone. And hence, you see, in this manner, we cannot actually make this allegation that these gopis have abandoned their houses in serving Krishna. Now you see another mood that I want to place before each one of you. So Shripad Jeev Goswami goes on to say that, Shripad Jeev Goswami goes on to say that. So it goes something like this. So imagining and assuming if Shri Krishna was to say something to the gopis, then he would have asked, so Shri Krishna is urging gopis to speak the truth.
So
you see, Shri Krishna goes on to say that on your strong, tough heart, you see there is so much of dirt and dust of sins.
अब देखो इसके पहले कृष्ण ने क्या कहा कि मेरा चरण कमल कठोर है और मैं आपके हृदय पर कैसे चरण रखूं. अब कृष्ण उल्टा कहते हैं कि तुम्हारे कठोर हृदय पर मैं मेरा चरण कैसे रखूं. एक आचार्य ने बहुत सुंदर कहा ये प्रेम है. और आज तक मैंने भी सुना था कि प्रेम की गति जो है ना वक्र होती है, जैसे सांप चलता है. सांप कैसे चलता है, कभी राइट में कभी लेफ्ट में, कभी राइट में कभी लेफ्ट में है? थोड़ी देर पहले कृष्ण ऐसा कह रहे थे कि तुम्हारे हृदय कमल इतने कोमल हैं, मैं मेरा चरण कैसे रख दूं.
कृष्ण ऐसा कहते हैं कि तुम्हारा हृदय इतना कठोर है, मैं मेरा
कोमल चरण कमल कैसे रख दूं, मेरा कोमल सा चरण कमल तुम्हारे हृदय पर कैसे रखूं? तब
व्हाट इंटरेस्टिंगली श्री कृष्णा इज सेइंग टू कॉन्ट्रडिक्टरी थिंग्स एट वन प्लेस ही सेज दैट योर हार्ट इज सो टेंडर हाउ कैन आई प्लेस माय फीट ऑन योर हार्ट एंड देन ऑन द अदर हैंड ही सेज दैट हाउ कैन ही प्लेस हिज टेंडर feet on the heart of the gopis. Now imagining, you see, Goswamiji goes on to say that if Shri Krishna can
Kaliyanak mastak par jo
his lotus feet on the Kaliyan snake,
jab us nag par aur us mani par
aap
तो तत्कथम
शं नॉट ओनली प्लेस्ड योर फीट लोटस फीट ऑन द हुड ऑफ द कालिया स्नेक एंड नॉट ओनली यू प्लेस्ड योर लोटस फीट बट दैट यू डांस्ड ऑन द हुड एज वेल एंड हेंस द गोपीज गो ऑन टू से ओ श्री कृष्णा यू वेंट ऑन टू प्लेस योर लोटस फीट ऑन द स्नेक कालिया एंड दैट यू डांस्ड ऑन द हुड ऑफ द सर्पेंट कालिया सो वी रिक्वेस्ट यू ओ श्री कृष्णा to place those divine feet on our hearts. So assuming if Shri Krishna was to tell the gopis that the gopis have performed huge sins, so Shri Krishna shall not place his lotus feet on their hearts. So gopis would answer that, O Shri Krishna, was not Kaliya a sinner? Even Kaliya serpent had committed strong sins, but still you placed your lotus feet on his hood. So we also say that we have also committed lot of sins, but just as you absolve Kaliya serpent of all his sins, similarly you please place your lotus feet on our hearts and absolve us of all our sins. Further, you see, just as you place your lotus feet on the hood of the serpent Kaliya and you went on to remove all the sins, so it was like as Shri Krishna placed his lotus feet on the hood of serpent Kaliya, he was absolved of all his sins. He used to throughout all his poison, and in this manner he was absolved of all his sins. So the gopis go on to make a request that just like serpent Kaliya, there is a lot of poison in our hearts, and that poison is the mood of being separated from you. So the fire of being separated from you. So those who consume poison, you see, it's a kind of fire lit inside. So just as serpent Kaliya had lot of poison and you place your lotus feet on its hood and he got absolved of all his poison. So similarly, we, the living entities, Veda gopis, also have that fire of poison of being separated from you. So just as you absolved his poison by placing a lotus feet on its hood, similarly, O Shri Krishna, that must you place your lotus feet on our head and help us be absolved of all the sins. So you see, Shri Krishna danced on the hood of serpent Kaliya and he placed his lotus feet on the heart of the gopis. So dear devotees, there is poison around our life as well. So you see, there's no difference between Krishna and his name. So similarly, we all devotees must ensure that the word Shri Krishna dances in our heart. We must be getting ourselves absolved of all the sins. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. And hence in this manner, O Shri Krishna, so the lotus feet that you have placed on the serpent Kalia, may you also place that upon us. So you see, if you see the second line of the shloka, if you attempt to understand the word padambuj, so O Shri Krishna, kindly place the divine feet on our hearts. So you see, there can be two meanings to padambuj. So Sanatan Goswami has given the first meaning. Padambuj means, you see, so it's like water, and those who sustain their life on the basis of water, just like the lotus.
Sadhu jatasa sarasi yodara shrimrusha drusha suratanat te shulkadasika varadani ghnato neha kim vadha. Padambuj shabd ki definition, unka arth pratham,
the definition of the term padambuj, charan kamal bhi keh sakti thi aapke charan, they could have said lotus feet also, but why padambuj? Because the lotus feet of Shri Krishna are very, very beautiful. And what is the extent of beauty? That in the winter season, so the water of winter season, so in the winter season, the water goes on to purify itself. But in the rainy season, the water goes on to get polluted. So the water is very, very clean in the winters.
जैसे साधुओं में सभी गुण होते हैं, भगवान से भी अधिक गुण साधुओं में होते हैं, तो पूर्ण खिले हुए शरद ऋतु के निर्मल जल में सरसीज,
so the lotus which gets bloomed in the winter season, so the central part of the lotus and its beauty, so you see, your lotus feet goes on to hide away the beauty of the lotus of the winter season. Such beautiful are your lotus feet. Now Sanatan Goswami goes on to say that this is meant for, this is an explanation for the beauty of the lotus feet. But further, you see, we can understand this by way of Sri Sanatan Goswami. Sanatan Goswami goes on to say that Oh Shri Krishna, your lotus feet is the source of all sources. So not just that it is the source of all sources, it is not just the source, but it is also the objective. So suppose if you need to go to place B from place A and you use a car, so that is the source. So similarly, to reach the Lord and Bhagavat Prem, what is the biggest source? The lotus feet of the Lord. So you see, at the end of Bhagavatam, therefore, it was said that so you see, for people like us who are devotees, the lotus feet of the Lord is the source of all sources. So you see, what is the biggest achievement in our lives? So it is said that the lotus feet of Shri Krishna is the biggest objective and goal one can set for himself. What a beautiful explanation given by commentators. So you see, we do have a feel that we would be able to understand, but then it is not such a case. So you see, we all rather must make an attempt to also develop the feel as we listen. And you see, in Mahabharat also, something of this sort has been presented, which is at the bottom of your screens.
Mahabharat.
So in 12th canto, so Shri Vyas Muni goes on to say,
Krishnasya kritah pranamo te padam bujam shabda ke upar pranata dehi
naam. So
eko api mane ek bar bhi.
So it is said that even if once,
Krishnasya kritah pranama yadi koi vyakti,
so even for once an individual offers his pranam to Shri Krishna. And you know, it is like without any feeling, emotion or sentiment. So if anyone offers pranam to Shri Krishna, then so you see, the pranam at the lotus feet of the Lord once is equal to 10,000 Ashwamedh yagyas. So the result is worth 10 Ashwamedh yagna. So you see, so despite having made an attempt, you see, there is a possibility
So
you see how tough it is for the physical entity to come to this material world, and if one offers the obeisances at the lotus feet of the Lord, then he is not required to come back to this physical world. So you see, before we move further, let us proceed for a short break, and then we will move further with the shloka.
Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, 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 Hare Hare. So, bahut bahut dhanyawad. Shriman LalGovindDas ji ka. Bahut hi sundar hum pichle 3 din se lagatar keval is ek shlok ki ek hi line tak pahunche hain. To hum samajh sakte hain ki is shlok par aur kitni kitni vyakhyaen ho sakti hain. Phir bhi hum dekh rahe hain ki Prabhu ji sanchit mein kar rahe hain. To you know, bada hi saubhagya hai ki hame is prakar se ये श्री गोपी गीतम का इतनी विस्तृत रूप से रेस्पॉन्ड करा रहे हैं प्रभु जी. तो हम धन्यवाद करते हैं प्रभु जी का, और यही धन्यवाद हमारे यजमान परिवार का जिन्होंने ये बड़ा सौभाग्य हम सबको दिया है. तो आइए उनके ही सौभाग्य से जो हम श्री राधा गोविंद गौशाला में गौ माता की सेवा कर रहे हैं उनके भी दर्शन कर लें, और पुनः हम प्रभु जी के मुखारविंद से इस शेष कथा को रेस्पॉन्ड करेंगे. तो आइए चलते हैं गौशाला में. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. So, हमारे श्री रसिक प्रभु तथा भावना माता जी के सहयोग से हम यहाँ पर आज ये जो अद्भुत भागवत कथा का रेस्पॉन्स तो कर ही रहे हैं, परंतु साथ ही साथ ऐसी ही अद्भुत हमारी श्री गौ माता की सेवा हम यहाँ पर देख रहे हैं कि प्रतिदिन हो रही है इन महानुभाव के सहयोग से. साथ ही साथ हम स्मरण करना चाहेंगे आज हमारे शिल्पा माता जी, हमारे शिल्पा माता जी जो कि बहुत ही सुंदर भक्त थे. आज इनका जन्मदिन है. यू नो हमारे शिल्पा माता जी जो कि हमारे ये कौन से माता जी, हमारे गोपीनाथ वाले माता जी है, इनकी सिस्टर है एक्चुअली. I'm just missing her name actually. Sapna Mataji, yes, Sapna Mataji और Yashvi Mataji की mother और Sapna Mataji जिनकी sister हैं, तो उनकी आज जन्मदिन है. वैसे माताजी कुछ समय पूर्व, कुछ महीने पूर्व अपने इस भौतिक देह को त्याग कर गोलोक पास किए हैं, तो उनके स्मरण में भी उन्होंने आज यहाँ पर सहयोग किया है. और बड़ा ही सुंदर माताजी का भाव रहा है हमारे शिल्पा माताजी का, जो कि इनके अंदर उनके अंडर में यू नो जो इनकी क्वालिटीज थी हमें जानने को मिली कि किस प्रकार माताजी यू नो देयर वर हंड्रेड्स ऑफ एम्प्लॉइज वर्किंग अंडर हर, यू नो उनकी ऑफिस में काम करते थे, परंतु उनके अंदर एक ये सुंदर गुण था कि जब भी व्हेन सी यूज्ड टू कुक सी यूज्ड टू ऑफर द फर्स्ट रोटी टू द गौ माता, जो हमारी संस्कृति रही है. यू नो जो हमने उनकी सिस्टर से ये जाना कि व्हाट अ वंडरफुल, हम निश्चित गो माता से यही प्रार्थना करेंगे उनके लिए, उनके तथा उनके परिवार के लिए कि यू नो माता जी डेफिनेटली सी हैज अचीव्ड द हाईएस्ट डेस्टिनेशन, परंतु साथ ही साथ जो उनके जो ये जो परिवार जन है उनको भी ऐसी ऊर्ध्वगति प्राप्त हो, और वह भी इस प्रकार यू नो इस गो सेवा में तथा वैष्णव की सेवा में संलग्न रहे. तो हम प्रार्थना करेंगे गौ माता से तथा हमारे और ये जो भगवान से, तथा आप सबसे भी हम निवेदन करें कि यदि आप यू नो आपके पास थोड़ा भी अवकाश है, समय है, तो हमारे शिल्पा माता जी के लिए जरूर प्रार्थना कीजिएगा, बिकॉज शी वॉज वेरी वंडरफुल, वेरी डेडिकेटेड, डिवोटेड. यू नो प्रभु जी की कथा में उनको इतनी रुचि आती थी, उनकी उस अवस्था के उस अवस्था में भी जब वो व्हेन शी वॉज सपोज्ड टू लीव हर बॉडी, यू नो सी नेवर यूज टू सी नेवर मिस्ड प्रभु जी कथा. तो यू नो ऐसे भक्त है जिनकी इतनी अद्भुत रुचि थी यू नो भगवत कथा के प्रति, कृष्ण कथा के प्रति. तो नो अगर हम ऐसे वैष्णव के लिए प्रार्थना करेंगे तो निश्चित यू नो भगवान हमारे लिए भी ऐसी व्यवस्था करेंगे कि हम भी हमारे जीवन के उस अंतिम क्षणों में भगवान को तथा कृष्ण कथा को यू नो श्रवण करेंगे, कर सकेंगे. तो आप सबसे भी निवेदन है कि आप उनके लिए विशेष प्रार्थना कीजिएगा, आप थोड़ा सा समय निकाल कर उनके लिए विशेष प्रार्थना करिए, ताकि वह माता जी यू नो भगवान श्री कृष्ण के इस चरणों में उनकी सेवा हमेशा के लिए इसी प्रकार अर्पण करती रहे. और साथ ही साथ यदि आप भी व्यक्ति आप लोग भी में से किसी की ऐसी इच्छा है कि आप इस प्रकार गो सेवा करना चाहते हैं तो आप हमें अप्रोच कर सकते हैं हमारे इस कॉन्टेक्ट डिटेल्स में जहां पर हम आपको इस विषय में और अधिक जानकारी दे सकते हैं जो कि आप नंबर यहाँ पर स्क्रीन पर देख रहे हैं। तो ये हमारा कॉन्टेक्ट डिटेल है श्री राधा गोविंद गौशाला में, आप इस विषय में और सूचना यहाँ पर प्राप्त कर सकते हैं 7567545555 पर, तथा आप हमें ईमेल भी कर सकते हैं sevaperfect@gmail.com और आप हमारी वेबसाइट पर जाकर इस वेबसाइट की इस गोप सेवा की गतिविधियों को भी आप वहां पर दर्शन कर सकते हैं विच इज ऑन www.perfectseva.com। सभी वैष्णव से निवेदन है कि आप अपने जीवन में आने वाले ऐसे पर्व को अवश्य ही गौ माता के संग में सेलिब्रेट करें ताकि हमें भगवान तथा गौ माता की कृपा को प्राप्त कर सके और यू नो इस प्रकार कृष्ण भक्ति में हम उन्नति कर सके। सो थैंक यू वेरी मच। और साथ ही साथ हम ये भी आप सबको बताना चाहते हैं कि आने वाले जो कार्तिक फेस्टिवल है जिसको कि हम सेलिब्रेट करने वाले हैं इसी ऑनलाइन प्लेटफॉर्म के माध्यम से, तो आप सब इसमें आमंत्रित है। विशेष यू नो गोविंद टीवी ने बहुत ही सुंदर व्यवस्था की है हमारे लिए कि जहाँ पर हम ये जो आने वाला ये सुंदर पर्व है हमारे जीवन में यू नो कार्तिक इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट वेरी डियर टू श्रीमती राधा रानी एक्चुअली। तो आप सबसे निवेदन है कि हमारे साथ इस महीने में बने रहिएगा, आने वाली 15 तारीख से लेकर 26 नवंबर तक ये फेस्टिवल्स हम सेलिब्रेट करते रहेंगे इसी प्लेटफॉर्म के माध्यम से और बहुत ही सुंदर हम ब्रज 84 कोस यात्रा के दर्शन करेंगे इस प्लेटफॉर्म के माध्यम से। और गत वर्ष की ही भांति बहुत सुंदर व्यवस्था है इस बार भी, हम घर बैठे जो व्यक्ति हमारे साथ में जुड़ रहे हैं दो दे आर मोस्ट वेलकम, बट स्टिल है ना जो भक्त अपने स्थान पर है जो नहीं निकल पा रहे हैं कुछ कारणवश उनके लिए यहाँ पर इतनी अद्भुत व्यवस्था है कि वो घर बैठे भी पुनः एक बार फिर से यहाँ पर ये सारी व्यवस्था का लाभ ले सकता है, उन सारे स्थानों को अपने ही घर में बैठकर दर्शन कर सकता है। और इसी के साथ साथ अद्भुत भागवत कथा तो हम श्रवण करने वाले ही हैं श्री दामोदर अष्टकम के विषय में तथा दामोदर लीलाओं का श्रवण करेंगे प्रभु जी के मुखारविंद से, तथा हमने ये भी जाना कि अंत के दिनों में हम श्रीमती तुलसी महारानी जी की लीलाओं के विषय में प्रभु जी के मुखारविंद से श्रवण करेंगे। तो कुल मिलाकर यू नो ये जो पावर पैक मंथ हमें मिल रहा है कार्तिक और उसमें इतनी अद्भुत अद्भुत कथाएं हम श्रवण करने वाले हैं, साथ ही साथ इतने दिव्य स्थानों का दर्शन भी करने वाले हैं, तो आप सब इसमें आमंत्रित हैं। इसीलिए आप सबसे ये हम प्राउडली शेयर कर रहे हैं ताकि आप अपने आप को शेड्यूल कर सको और इन अद्भुत कार्यक्रम में हमारे साथ में जुड़ सको। सो बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद एक बार फिर से आप सभी भक्तों का कि आप यहाँ पर हमारे साथ में जुड़े ही हैं, परंतु आइए अब हम निवेदन करें पुनः श्रीमान लाल गोविंद जी से कि हम इस श्रेष्ठ कथा को श्रवण करें उनके मुखारविंद से। हरे कृष्ण।
प्राणात देहिना पाप कर्षणम् त्रिणचरानुगम् श्रीनिकेतनम् पणिपणार्पितम् ते पदाम्बुजम् पणिपणार्पितम् ते पदाम्बुजम् कृणोकुचेशुना क्रिन्धिरीचयम् कृणोकुचेशुना क्रिन्धिरीचयम् प्रणत देही नाम इसका परिचय हो गया।
So we have understood प्रणत देही नाम पाप कर्षण नाम। Also we have understood तुरंचरानुगम and श्रीनिकेतनम। Also we have understood फणि फणार्पितम ते पदाम्बुजम। Also has been understood। Now, let us try to understand. Krunu kucheshunah krindi richayam. Let us attempt to understand this. So you see, we all must understand one thing. From the material world's point of view, only when you get into serious contemplation that you can experience the blissful and meaningful realization of this wonderful Gopi Gita. So from material point of view, and that if you do not have a serious contemplation, you would not be able to understand the real meaning of this Gopi Gita, and rather we might end up committing an offense. So we must look at it very differently. The gopis go on to say, O Shri Krishna, kindly place divine lotus feet of yours. Kindly place your lotus feet upon our heart. And the flame of our heart, the fire of our heart, be extinguished by you. So, if I was to ask you why at all the gopis want to get placed the lotus feet of Shri Krishna on their heart, you see, so the mood and affection is very, very deep. But looking at it from ordinary point of view, then the reason why the gopis want Sri Shyamasundar to place his lotus feet on their heart is, number one, that comparing to all other organs of the body, the glory of heart is far more ahead in any other organ of the body. It is the heart which, if protected, then the rest of the body can be protected. And also, if you see, if the entire body is good, but then if heart is not good, then what happens? So you see, we have been a witness to this fact that the body might be really good, but if heart doesn't function well, then the body makes no sense, has no meaning. So because heart is more strongly preferred and is more significant than the rest of the body, that is the reason the gopis look forward for getting the lotus feet of the Lord placed on their heart. Now if you see, if you place a lamp in the dark house, it goes on to spread light, illuminate the entire house. Similarly, if you see, the Lord is in the heart, but the Lord who stays in the heart, his light, his illumination goes on to reach every part of the body. Now, if I was to also share some basic knowledge with you, that have you ever wondered that all the incarnations of the Lord, why did they happen only in India? So don't you think if one or two incarnations could have been there in America or London? So, by way of Gopi Gita, you know, one reason I would share with you that why the incarnations of the Lord only took place in India, because in Srimad Bhagavatam there is a mention of Virat Roop. And then all the universe from the feet to the head of the Lord.
Bhagavan Virat ka charan gutan is prakar se hota hai. Bhagavan Virat ka hriday hai Bharatvarsh.
So, India or Bharat is the heart of Virat Roop of the Lord. So, if we consider the Virat Roop of the Lord, then Bharat or India is the heart of the Lord. And because India is the heart of the Virat Roop of the Lord, that is the reason all incarnations take place in India. So you see, the gopis never went to understand and study this principle, but when the mood and sentiment is pure, then you see these realizations do happen. So you see, where did this manushya come from? From Manu Maharaj. So as everyone come from Manu Maharaj, they came to be called as Manu Maharaj. So it is Manu Maharaj who gave rise to all manushya. And then all the manushya went on to split in different directions. But in Manu Smriti, Manu Maharaj goes on to say a very beautiful thing. So Manu Maharaj goes on to say the shloka before you at the bottom of your screens. So you see, people from countries other than India must always remember this shloka. So Manu Maharaj says, this country called Bharat, so Manu Maharaj goes on to say that the saint, the sadhu or the sage who would be born in this country called India or Bharat,
the sages
and saints be followed by the one who would be born in India. So, Manu Maharaj, after giving birth to the people, they said that you might be born anywhere, but whom do you need to follow? You need to follow the one who have been born in Bharat. So it is like, you see, the world might get destroyed, but if India remains safe, then the entire world remains safe. So the culture, the shastras, the sages and sadhus, if they are safe in Bharat, then the entire world is safe. But then if you see, if there is derailment of this in Bharat, then there would be problems everywhere, because it is Bharat which is the heart. So if you talk about 14 bhuvans, Earth is placed at the center, and in, if you talk about the center of the earth, it is Bharat. And that is the reason gopis want to request Shri Krishna to place his lotus feet at the heart of gopis. So gopis go on to say in a very weeping manner, cheerful manner. So, such a wonderful mood of the gopis, that come what may, be highly praised a person been born in a high family and that has attained best of the education. But so far as the heart of such a person it's not decorated with Radha Shyam Sundar, then you see everything is meaningless.
Idrisha purush bhushanena ya bhushayanti radayam na subruva Diktadiya kulashila yovanam, diktadiya guna rupa sampada. Bahut badi baat gopiyon ne kahi.
This is a very deep expression given by the gopis. So the objective of all the devotees, so the aim of all the devotees should always be that the lotus feet of the Lord be placed at our heart. Such Lord, the best amongst all men, or
भगवान श्री कृष्ण के चरण को अपने हृदय पर रखकर भूषयंती हृदय को आभूषित नहीं करते, अलंकृत नहीं करते, तो दिक्तम धिक्कार है उस जीवन को, धिक्कार है उस
अलास इस अलास दैट अ डिवोटी who ignores so a devotee who does not look forward for the lotus feet of Sri Krishna be placed on their heart despite knowing so much, then it is very unfortunate on the part of that devotee. So it is as we are saying that your physical body is quite beautiful and impressive, but if there is no lotus feet of Sri Krishna on your heart, then everything else is meaningless. Not only unfortunate is he, but his family and also his extended family.
उसका कितना भी अच्छा शील हो वो शील भी धिक्कार है यौवनम धिक उसकी जवानी भी धिक्कार है
सो बी इट हिज यूथडम बी हिज वेल्थ बी हिज अपीयरेंस एवरीथिंग इज मीनिंगलेस जस्ट इन केस इफ ही डस नॉट हैव द लोटस फीट ऑफ द लॉर्ड ऑन हिज हार्ट सो In Anand Vrindavan Champu, this is the mood of the gopis. And hence, you see, this is the duty of the devotee that he must get placed the lotus feet of the Lord on their heart. You see the main shloka, which is there on the screens before you, within the red borders, that O Shri Krishna, O Shri Krishna, help us in this. So you see, this is a style of gopis that they are saying indirectly and taking all the blame to themselves. So can you imagine if Kam can go on to sit in the heart of the gopis? But the gopis go on to say that let the cardinal desires of our be extinguished. So the mood is that even though the gopis eagerly look forward to serve the means to Sri Krishna, but the real hunger is in the hearts of the gopis. So you see, the mood is really very, very highly placed. And that is the reason that when Sri Krishna appeared and Sri Krishna got to know that the gopis do not have any other work, they do not have any hunger, they had been praying only for me. Then Sri Krishna appears and Sri Krishna starts weeping and crying. And you see, Sri Krishna says that I might take crores of births, but I shall never be able to pay back your debt. You have indebted me. because you do not have any desire in your heart but that you have done all this only for me. 10th canto, 32nd chapter, 22nd shloka of Srimad Bhagavatam. Shri Krishna, overwhelmed by such a gesture, addresses the gopis like this.
Swasadhu krutyam vibhudayusha piya yama bhajandu jargeha shrinkhala samvrusha tadva pratiyatu sadhuna. Krishna kehte hain.
So Shri Krishna goes on to say, oh dear gopis, the favor that you have bestowed upon me, I would never ever be able to pay that back. Oh dear gopis, I can never pay back to you. Such huge humility, such truthfulness in you, that in order to make me happy, you went on to say that you have the carnal desire. So there is not even an iota of selfishness in you, and that you see you are taking all the blame to yourself. Oh dear gopis, you have broken open the chains of your challenging family life, ignoring your husbands and the society. You have come on to surrender completely to me. You are greatly placed and great entities.
Krishna se khub prem kare.
So you see, this is what we must learn from the gopis, that we must learn how to love Sri Krishna from gopis. But must you not make Sri Krishna have a feel of it? Such a love becomes very shallow. So you see, when Sri Krishna gets to know the reality, he feels indebted towards you. And you see, these gopis are presenting their mood and affection spontaneously and instantly. But the acharyas went on to capture the mood and sentiment of the gopis. And you see, in the Rig Vedas, so this is one of the shloka of Rig Veda. So in Taittiriya Upanishad, so in 4.19, this has been expressed. So gopis went on to say by way of sentiment, but then this is, it's described in the Vedas. So you see the shloka on the bottom of your screen in yellow border.
So what
Gopi said, similar thing has been found in the Vedas. So you see, Vedas go after love and affection. So the meaning goes something like this. So So Dev here means Shri Krishna. So the one who is self-illuminated, so the lotus feet of the Lord, and especially the one who has danced on the hood of Kaliya Nag. So
So we
are listening to the glories of Shri Krishna. So what is the nature of Shravanam and Kirtan of Shri Krishna? So what is the nature? Which is unpolluted, all holy. So such Lord Shri Krishna and the fame of such Lord Shri Krishna. So such devotees of Braj. So they experience eternal happiness and pleasure. And the Brajvasis and Gopis have a desire to get placed the lotus feet of Shri Krishna on their hearts. And for that to happen, the different names of Shri Krishna is being recited by them, and then they engage in meditation, kirtan in the name of the Lord. And hence in this manner, this mantra is there in one of the rituals of Rigveda. And hence in this manner, the love of the gopis is really differently placed. So assuming if Shri Krishna was to say that if you have a desire that my lotus feet be placed on your heart, then what else do you need? Then the gopis say that merely placing the lotus feet on our heart shall not work. So the logic is that so the pitfalls, the shortfalls outside the body have been eliminated. But then that there are certain wounds inside. And in order to extinguish those sins in the heart, you see, one must be offered and offered some medicine. So then the gopis go on to say that it is this particular medicine.
Buddha mano gaya pushkare kshana vidhi kari rima viramu yati adharasi dhuna pyaya swana adharasi dhuna Krishna, aapke charan kamal se hamara baharik taap samapt hua.
Oh, Shri Krishna, by your lotus feet, the flame of the outside world is extinguished, but now please offer us the two types of elixir. So we shall elaborate upon this in tomorrow's katha.
इंट्रोडक्शन दिया है इसमें बहुत सारी बातें आचार्यों के द्वारा है हम भी थोड़े से साधना भक्ति करके तैयार हो जाए थोड़ी योग्यता हासिल करें तो आगे चलकर किसी संत आचार्य के द्वारा इस उच्च भाव को हम सुन सकते हैं मैं केवल परिचय दे रहा हूं सातवें श्लोक का परिचय हुआ और भावना माता ने कहा था कि इत्मीनान से आप अपने भाव से कीजिए
सो यू सी आई डू नॉट वांट टू हरी or rush through things because Bhavna Mataji had asked me to go very comfortably. So I would take my own pace. So I'm enjoying as I'm moving slowly and gradually. So once again, thanks to each one of you. We shall now meet tomorrow. So special thanks to the host family, Patel family, Sikh Prabhu and Bhavna Mata and the entire family. So we shall meet tomorrow. Hare Krishna, Radhe Shyam.
Grantaraj Shrimad Bhagavatam Mahapuran Ki Sri Krishna Chandra Bhagavan